crazy offensively. Well, looks a guy who's bounced around. He's been with Houston, the Jets. He's with Cincinnati, the Giants, and Pittsburgh in 2016. Cincinnati, Tennessee, the last 2 years. He's back with the Giants in his fifth game. As DeVito and company try to set him up for the game-winning try. Here is Barkley. It's fourth down, so the Giants will let the clock wind down, take their timeout, and Randy Bullock will walk center stage.
I know they got a few more. I'm surprised they even did what they just did. I thought they would just pretty much take a knee and let the clock run down and not risk anything, but they did secure the ball, and now we'll see if they can finish it off with Randy Bullock.
About a 36-yard try. And in his 11th season, you see his record 7 for 13 on lead-changing field goal attempts in the final 2 minutes of the fourth or overtime. We're down to one more snap. Barring a defensive penalty.
Looks like he's got a lot going through his mind right now.
Officially 37 yards. Two quarterbacks trade huge throws down the stretch. The touchdown throw to Blake Heath. And then Tommy DeVito, it was his turn. And on that last drive, 4 for 4. 53 yards, including that 32-yarder to Wandale Robinson to put the Giants in position for the game-winning field goal by Randy Bullock. Dillon got the laces out of the way, and Randy Bullock did the rest. Say it again, there's a lot going on with Tommy DeVito and the stories and the parents and everything going on in the stands. This young man played a really good football game here tonight for the New York Giants.
He really did, and he helped bail out that guy, Saquon Barkley, after the fumble. And for Jordan Love, who had struggled for a good part of the night, when the game was on the line, he made the plays, and he was able to take his team down the field and take the lead. But Tommy DeVito, the fairy tale continues.
What a moment for the family section, family and friends of Tommy. Let's go down to Lisa Salters.
Thank you, Joe. Well, Tommy, just what were you thinking when you took the field with a minute and a half to go in the game on the line?
Just stay calm and do our operation. We do it every single day before practice. We do a two-minute drill, so to come out here and execute the way we did, offensive line, receivers, route depth, I mean, touching the ball, getting up north one down like they're a huge one, but really testament to those guys in our practice habits.
Such a clean game, no sacks, just 4 incompletions. You had 71 yards rushing. Just how do you think you played tonight?
I thought I played a little slow in the first half, to be honest. Some throws I want back. I missed that third one down in the first quarter. I think it was the first or second drive, and hit him right there when it mattered. So that's it. Just trying to get better each and every day. Good, look forward to watching the film.
What have the last 3 weeks been like for you?
It's been a lot. It's been a lot of fun getting wins. I'll tell you that. I know how it goes when you're winning or when you're losing. But I'm just trying to stay even keel throughout the whole thing and just enjoy my teammates.
So the dream continues. Just why hasn't this moment, these moments, why haven't they been too big?
I've been playing football since I was 5 years old. I mean, I've been doing it for a long time. I know it's a bigger stage, a lot more on the line, but at the end of the day, I try to have fun with it. It's a kid's game, so I just try to enjoy it.
Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Guys.
Yeah, they can all enjoy it. Tonight, Tommy, no turnovers, no sacks, 4 incompletions all game.
And the young man who lives at home with his parents and his brother and enjoys his mom's chicken cutlets was phenomenal here tonight. And that family is going to be celebrating deep into the night. You just know that. That family's getting bigger by the minute. We talked to him about his mom's cooking, and he said it's unbelievable. She's a great cook, but she hasn't had to cook much, as you said earlier, because people in the neighborhood have been dropping off food every day. It's a great story. He played a great game. Congratulations to the Giants. The Packers slipped to 6-7. There's our game next Monday night. Eagles at the Seahawks. Big game for both. Titans and Dolphins still going on ESPN. Check that out. Next week, the Eagles visit Seattle on ESPN and ABC. I can't get enough of that picture. Your late local news is coming up next here on ABC, except on the West Coast. What a night. At least they so long from MetLife Stadium.